Good morning.
Good morning.
My name is Pastor Dale Clem, and I, along with Pastor Terry Milstead, are glad to have you here this morning. She'll be preaching for us later on. And we're really excited to welcome our visitors, especially our scouts from the three troops that our church sponsors. So we're glad that you're here. Welcome, welcome. This is an exciting Sunday for us. We're in the midst of Lent, the Lenten season, and exploring different prayer practices. And today is intercessory prayer. It's where we pray for others. So it's exciting to get the chance to kind of go deeper into what intercessory prayer is today. And you're in for a treat with a surprise guest in a video. I invite you now, as we worship, to stand, if you're able, for our call to worship. Come now, let us reason together, says the Lord. Though your sins are like scarlet, they shall be like snow.
Though they are red like crimson, they shall become like wool.
Come, in returning and rest, you shall be saved.
In quietness and in trust shall be your strength.
Our opening hymn today is, Come, Ye Sinners Poor and Needy. Let us sing together. Let us remain standing and say together the historic profession of faith, the Apostles' Creed. I believe in God the Father Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, and in Jesus Christ, his only Son, our Lord, who was conceived by the Holy Spirit, born of the Virgin Mary, suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, dead, and buried.
The third day he rose from the dead. He ascended into heaven and sitteth at the right hand of God the Father Almighty. From thence he shall come to judge the quick and the dead. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and the life everlasting. Amen.
I want to welcome everyone here that's worshiping with us here in person, also online today, and we are just connected in all kinds of ways, virtually as well as in person. And you'll want to know that we have a church-wide picnic coming up on Palm Sunday in just a few weeks, and you can go online to sign up, and you can order a box lunch if you'd like, and we'll also have an Easter egg hunt at that time. Also, during Holy Week, we'll be having Maundy Thursday service at 6:30 at Restore, and at 6:30 on Friday, a Good Friday service here in the sanctuary, and on Good Friday at noon, we'll have a service here in the sanctuary. Then on Easter morning, we'll have at 6:30 in the morning a service. I think it's 6:30. It's early anyway. Chicken 30. What time is it, Terry? Terry's preaching. She's real excited. So it'll be at the Labyrinth outside, an outdoor service, and then we'll have 8:30 and 10 o'clock services at Restore, and 9 o'clock and 11 o'clock services here in the sanctuary. So five opportunities to worship on Easter. And of course, they'll be virtually as well. The 8:30 and the 11 o'clock service will be virtually broadcast. The trustees are having a work day here at the church next Saturday, March 20th. They'll meet at 8 o'clock here at the Founding Church. And the youth have collected enough stuff for Easter baskets for 50 persons that are in need for this Easter season. They still need some candy and some Easter grass if you'd like to donate that. Well, today is a big day as we welcome our scouts and scout leaders for Scout Sunday. And I want to invite Tim and Robert and Jay to come up and bring us some greeting. And as they're coming, if you've ever been involved in scouting, could you stand? Y'all are involved now. See? So you guys are in good stead. There's a lot of scout folks here. I think you can be seated.
All right, good morning. Good morning. My name is Tim Robinson. I'm the scout master for Troop 548. First, I would just like to say, give thanks. I would like to thank the church, thank you, the body of Christ, for being our charter organization, for providing us a space for these outstanding young men to meet for the Scout program. It has been challenging, like it has for everyone, and tragic during this season. I'd ask that we continue to remember the Conlon family and their loss as they have been involved in the scouting program longer than myself, and I cannot remember being part of Troop 548 without them. Also, many of you know our former scoutmaster, who is our current council chairman, Danny Goggins. Danny continues to battle with an illness that has kept him away from most things And we really miss having him around. You know, he was our Scoutmaster for 50 years. So that is a stewardship that likely won't be repeated, and we definitely miss having him. For some of the highlights of what we've done this year, we attended winter camp in Mentone, Alabama, just after Christmas. Many of these guys were there. We had a really great time. They learned a lot. I think the probably the highlight of that time was the automotive merit badge, where these guys got to learn how to change oil and do stuff that a lot of times they don't get to anymore, or that some of us who are older had to do out of necessity. So that was a lot of fun to hear about that. And we have a really loaded summer coming up. Our high adventure trip last year was canceled due to COVID. So we get to take 8 scouts this year to Ely, Minnesota, which is just 10 minutes south of the Canadian border. It's a canoe trip. It's going to be about 40 miles by canoe. And for about 5 to 8 of those miles, we're going to have to carry the canoe. That's going to be my least favorite part of the trip. But these guys are really excited to do that. It's one of the high adventure bases that the scouting program offers. And then we're also going, I'm really excited about going to Sea Base, which is in the Florida Keys. It's in the Middle Keys, which is where I spent my youth. So I'm really excited about that. We're going to take 16 scouts this June, and those guys are going to get to snorkel, they're going to fish, they're going to have a good time there, going to learn a lot about conservation, and so that's going to be a lot of fun. But in closing, again, just I can't say thank you enough. This is an outstanding group of young men, and without you, you know, they wouldn't have the program and be able to enjoy the opportunities that they do. So thank you.
Good morning. I'm Robert Jay. I'm the new Scoutmaster for Troop 1120, which is the Boy Scout side for the young ladies ages 11 to 18. We are 4 months into it, and so I just want to say thank you all. Thank you to Pastor Dale. Thank you for the executive committee, the congregation, for your support. And we would like to present to you our charter for the 2021 scouting year. Thank you all so much.
Well, we at Alabaster First United Methodist Church are just excited to be able to sponsor the troops and help, you know, help so much, the provide that place. And because the generosity of this congregation, from those that are watching online as well as those that are here today, you're able to have heating. Well, I don't know if y'all have heat too much. We're at Restore, but
we're fine.
You're fine. You have a place, a place to meet, and we give thanks for that. And a member of our church who's involved in the scouting program has put together some pictures for us about this, some of the programs. So let's watch the screen.
May your hands always be busy. May your feet always be swift. May you have a strong foundation when the winds of change shift. And may your heart always be joyful. May your song always be sung. And may you stay forever young. May you stay forever young.
Let us pray for all the gifts We give you thanks, O God, for the ways that you bless our lives and bless these scouts and all of and touch their lives through nature and exploring and learning and teamwork, community. We give you thanks. We ask, Lord, that you just send your blessing on the scout leaders this week, this year. Just guide them in all their endeavors and be with all the girls and the boys as they learn about your love and your world, and they learn the skills that they need that will lead them through the rest of their lives. Bless all the gifts and the givers. These things we pray in Christ's name. Amen. There are plates here at the front, and you can give online a variety of ways, and you can, during the service sometime, you can come up and offer a gift if you'd like. Let's again thank our scouts and their leaders today.
You may be seated. For those of you who are here with us this morning, I felt like it was proper that we should meditate during our time of prayer on our prayer concerns printed in our bulletin. So I ask you to place those before you and let us pray. Gracious Heavenly Father, we are thankful that you are a God who wants us to come before you, not just with our own concerns, but with those concerns of those around us. This morning, we take a moment to pause and consider the names that have been lifted up by this church community and printed in our bulletin. And as we take a moment to read over those and lift them up to you silently, each one of us, we also invite names to be lifted up in our own hearts in the silence or spoken out loud. Lord, in your great mercy, hear our prayers. And now we join our voice together, a community of believers, in the words of the prayer that Jesus taught his followers. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory forever. Amen. And now I'd like to invite our children forward for our children's moment.
Our next hymn is What a Friend We Have in Jesus. If you're able, we invite you to stand as we sing it together. Would you pray with me the prayer of illumination? Lord, open our hearts and minds by the power of your Holy Spirit, that as the scriptures are read and your word proclaimed, we may hear with joy what you say to us today. Amen.
Today's scripture comes from the Gospel according to Luke, chapter 11, verses 9 through 13. So I say to you, ask, and it will be given you. Search, and you will find. Knock, and the door will be opened for you. For everyone who asks receives, and everyone who searches finds, and for everyone who knocks, the door will be opened. Is there anyone among you who, if your child asks for a fish, will give a snake instead of a fish? Or if a child asks for an egg, give a scorpion? If you then, who are evil, know how to give good gifts to your children, how much more will the Heavenly Father give the Holy Spirit to those who ask them? And this is the word of God for the people of God.
Thanks be to God.
You may be seated.
Well, welcome, Arthur, back to Alabaster First United Methodist Church. We're so glad to see you.
Yeah, man, I'm excited. I'm excited. I'm glad you invited me, and glad to kind of be back in the church in somewhat of a little way, even. Yeah.
That's great. Well, as you know, we're talking about prayer this Lenten season, and today we're talking about intercessory prayer. And so I just wonder what do you think about intercessory prayer? How do you practice that?
Oh man. It's always really interesting, because you know, you have your own kind of personal prayer life. So I always have different prayer requests of praying for different people. So I've got a couple soldiers right now that are going through some difficult things that I've kind of been carrying around. And so in the mornings and the evenings, I pray for them and their situations and the outcomes that they would like to see happen. I think also, just kind of encountering the different times that people just ask for you to pray for them, or hey, can you pray for a situation that my family's going through? Can you pray for, this job opportunity I have? And that those come in such a moment that I've developed some of those cases just praying for them right then, like as soon as I hear for them, and praying for that person, whether I'm, talking to them on the phone, praying for them as we're having a conversation, or waiting until afterwards. And so sometimes it's part of my normal prayer routine. Other times it's very spontaneous, kind of throughout the day as things kind of you encounter them. And so I think it's just this cornerstone, I think, of prayer life, and not just petitioning our needs to God, but being able to pray for each other, and just an expression of our love for others as well, for sure. I love chasing down those little nudges that God gives you, and to check on people and see what's going on. And I think those are rich expressions of, confirming to us that, God is using us, that we're a part of God's outreach to other people. But at the same time, it builds that relationship between other people. I think checking on each other, expressing support for each other, and, having those moments together really, really build relationships in a way that few other things can.
Sure. So these nudges don't come just to preachers, you think?
Oh no, absolutely. and I think that's, such a beautiful thing. I think maybe preachers, we might get asked to pray for people maybe a little bit more often than, if we weren't preachers. But it's that beautiful expression that all of us can do it. It's not like your and my prayers get, heard better by God. In fact, God might judge our prayers, a little bit more. If we weren't preachers, but, it's beautiful thing that all of us can do. Each of us are part of that priesthood of believers, of being sensitive to the Holy Spirit and God's, how God's moving us in each of our unique situations, with each of our unique relationships and gifts. And each and every one of us is a part of that.
One of the hard things that sometimes we deal with is when our prayers aren't answered. We pray for someone who's sick, and then it doesn't work out like we wish.
Yeah. I think prayer is always prayed intention. It's just the act of prayer. I think it is an expression of our humility, of admitting that there's only so much that we can do. There's only so much that we're in control of. And so we're lifting it up to the one who, is the Lord over all creation. I don't get to pick and choose how things turn out, but I can be consistent in that moment of trying to connect the life of God with the need that is being experienced in that moment. And so when prayers don't get answered, it hurts. It hurts a lot. And we're caught in this tension. When Lazarus died and sisters come out, and Martha, and she's got all these questions of Jesus, if you were there, or these questions of maybe things didn't have to turn out this way. Sometimes things don't get answered the way that we'd like, but God is ultimately in the midst of all things. And I think pointing to that reality is sometimes the most we can do in those moments.
God's with us no matter what. And so much of the time, we don't understand what's going on. We only see part of the picture. We just kind of have to pray like Jesus did in the garden, "Thy will be done." And I think part of our intercessory prayer is just trying to align our will with God's will, whatever that is, and just getting alignment with
with what God's doing in the world.
Yeah, and you know, there's this feeling sometimes too that I think prayer brings out in me especially, and maybe other people do it as well, that I'm not really sure what I want. You know, I'm not really sure what the best outcome is. I'm not sure, you know, what is needed in a particular moment.
It's just a great mystery, isn't it?
Yeah. I love the idea of, you know, us existing in the mystery. You know, I've never really been one to have all the right answers. You know, I don't have the right words to make things better. I don't have magic words that all of a sudden make people feel better or explain the situations that they're in. But the mystery of God is, you know, such a rich and beautiful thing that it comes into the most hurting circumstances sometimes and still can manage to bring peace, to bring love out in really difficult times.
Well, thank you so much, Arthur, for coming back to Alabaster and sharing with us this morning.
Yeah, absolutely. Absolutely. I really appreciate all of the prayers that people have written to me and the letters that were given to me that I'm still working my way through. I think, you know, even those that kind of treasure box of prayers and letters that was given are so interesting, because prayers that people wrote months ago are, you know, showing up in just the moments that me and my family need them.
You know that we love you from Alabaster, so feel surrounded by prayers and love.
Yeah, well, I appreciate y'all, and I have been praying for y'all and doing everything I can to come home.
Good to see Arthur. And I also want to say that every Sunday it's good to see more and more of you that I haven't seen during this whole time. It was just a quick statement that Pastor Arthur made in the course of the video that we saw, but it really caught my attention. Early in the interview with Pastor Dale, he said that he had some soldiers that were currently going through some difficult things, and he said he was carrying those things around with him. He was carrying others' difficult things around with him. I truly believe that there might not be a better definition of intercessory prayer than that. Intercessory prayer, though, if you want a more dictionary-like definition, is, like Dale mentioned earlier, the act of making a request to God on behalf of others. It is, as Arthur also mentioned, an expression of our love for others. When we care enough to remember the concerns of others, not just our own, and to go before God with these concerns on their behalf, that is indeed an expression of love for that other person. In this act of mediating on someone's behalf, we build not only our relationship with God in the act of prayer, but we also build our relationship with the person we are praying for. There is nothing that will make your heart more tender toward another person than to carry their burden to God in prayer every day. And intercessory prayer is not just something that can be done for the people you love and care for in your life, who have asked you to pray or you know are in need of prayer. Intercessory prayer is something that can be done for any person or any situation in your life, including for people you struggle in relationship with. You may have been told this in the past, but if you want to heal your relationship with someone, or if you want to mend your attitude towards someone, praying for that person is a good way to start. Sincerely praying for a person will eventually soften your heart toward them. Prayer builds relationships with God and with others. And prayer changes us, the people who pray. One of my favorite authors, Barbara Brown Taylor, tells a story in her book, An Altar in the World, about a friend of hers whose partner was dying. She says that one afternoon near the end, she listened to her friend pray, really pleading with God to do something, to work a miracle, to save his love's life. Later, she asked her friend about these prayers, and he quickly understood what she was asking. "You want to know if I really believe God will intervene like that?" He said, "I honestly don't think it through that way. I tell God what I want. I'm not smart enough or strong enough to do anything else. So I tell God what I want, and I trust God to sort it out." In today's scripture, we are told by Jesus to ask, and it will be given to us. But just as Barbara Brown Taylor's friend was unsure that God would intervene in his partner's life situation the way he wanted, we too know from experience that it is not as simple as asking and receiving. Yes, if an earthly father knows how to give good gifts to his child, then surely our heavenly Father knows how to give good gifts. But it is a mystery we cannot understand. What is given and what is not, what is healed and what is suffered, what is rescued and what is lost. Just before the passage in Luke that we heard this morning, Jesus taught his disciples how to pray the prayer we already said together this morning, the Lord's Prayer. And what do we know is one of the key petitions in that prayer? Thy will be done. This is sometimes the hardest prayer of all to make, especially when we have lived many years and have seen healing and have received saving grace, but we have also witnessed suffering and experienced loss. Thy will be done. This is going beyond asking of God and into searching for God. It is humbling ourselves and our wants, needs, and desires before the Lord of all creation, as Arthur so beautifully put it. It is admitting that we are not in control, but knowing who to kneel before and ask for help, knowing whose peace and presence to seek amid any and every storm. One last point that Arthur made that I want to highlight this morning is the idea of God nudges and acting upon them. How many times have you had a prayer answered by another person? Maybe a family member has been right by your side when you needed support. Maybe a friend or a neighbor took care of things you did not have the time or wherewithal to take care of in a time of struggle. Maybe a stranger said just the thing you needed to hear in a moment you felt you were at the bottom of a pit you would not get out of. How many times have you had prayer answered by another person? In other words, how many times has the door you and other prayer warriors have been knocking on your behalf been answered by a real life flesh and blood person? Prayer, you see, is at least in part about being open to those God nudges to do something more than just pray. How many times this is how the door is open to our knocking? Remember, even if you currently find yourself in a place where you are furiously knocking on that door looking for God, you are almost also certainly in a place where you could open the door to someone else's knock. Intercessory prayer will not only put you in a place of not just knocking, but also of hearing the knock of others. Reverend Ryan Dunn puts it this way: intercessory prayer is meddlesome. It is not some throwaway, give it to God and leave it alone kind of thing. Intercessory prayer exposes us to how we can be in action on God's behalf. Matthew West, a contemporary Christian singer and songwriter, had a popular song about 6 years ago now called Do Something. The lyrics of the song begin this way. I woke up this morning, saw a world full of trouble now, thought, how did we get this far down? And how's it ever going to turn around? So I turned my eyes to heaven. I thought, God, why don't you do something? I just couldn't bear the thought of people living in poverty, children sold into slavery. The thought disgusted me. So I shook my fist at heaven and said, God, why don't you do something? And he said, I did. I created you. He's right. He's absolutely right. The book of James puts it differently when it says, if a brother or sister is naked and lacks daily food, and one of you says, go in peace, keep warm, and eat your fill. What is that? That's a prayer. If one of you says to your brother or sister in need, go in peace, keep warm, eat your fill, and yet you do not supply their bodily needs, what is the good of that? So faith by itself, if it has no works, is dead. Or maybe prayer without works. Intercessory prayer is a gift, a meddlesome, active gift. It is the gift of carrying the burdens of others in love before God. It is the gift of searching for God's will in all things. It is the gift of knocking on the very gates of heaven and finding that He is there with us through it all. And sometimes it is the gift of being the one who hears the knock and opens the door. May we all go from this place this week convicted to act, ask, search, and knock. May we be prepared to be answered in His will. And may we be ready to be His answer. In the name of Jesus, with the power of the Holy Spirit, for the glory of God. Let us pray. Gracious Heavenly Father, we thank You for placing people on our hearts and minds that we can then bring before You and ask for You to intercede in their struggles and difficulties. But Lord, we also thank You that You nudge us in the very moment that we lift up these names to You. You nudge us to move forward and to show Your love and Your answer to these people. Lord, empower us this week to do so wherever we go, in the name of Your Son, Jesus Christ. Amen. And would you stand for our closing hymn, Grace Greater Than Our Sin?
All the grace of all glory.
So go forth, prayer warriors. Continue to lift up those in need in your life and listen for God's nudge to take action. In the name of the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit, go in peace. Amen.